What's going on, Nation? Today I'm gonna be just going through the motions. I'm gonna do a bit of a leg workout combined with some, you know, advanced calisthenics type stuff and a little bit of abdominal stuff as well. I've been traveling for the past 3 weeks. I really haven't touched my legs in probably 3 weeks total. That's a long time to go without doing a leg routine, but it couldn't have been helped. All the stuff that I did while I was traveling was more circuit-based, so anything heavyweight related was just out of the question. So for me personally though, when I get back from not lifting for that long, that first week back in the gym just absolutely kills me. And so I like to take advantage of doing something like kind of like a going through the motions routine where I'm gonna utilize some of the exercises that I do in my leg workouts, but I'm not gonna hit them as hardcore as I possibly can, and I'm not gonna go as heavy as I normally can as well. Because I know that if I hit it super hard, my body's not used to it, and I'm gonna be so sore for the next probably week to week and a half that it's gonna affect my next workout. And you have to keep that in mind when you're lifting. You know, as you start to know your body and learn your body, you're gonna go through times where you don't lift for a little bit, whether you're sick or it's a holiday or you're traveling or anything like that. You need to know how your body responds. For me, my upper body usually can jump back pretty quick, and I think that's mainly due to the fact that I'm always using my upper body, whether I'm picking things up or putting things down or, you know, getting out of bed or closing the refrigerator door. I'm always moving my upper body, so things loosen up pretty quick. But legs, I'm sitting a lot of the day. You know, I'm in front of the computer answering your questions. So if I know if I hit this leg workout hard, my legs are just gonna be stiff and it's gonna kill me on my next workout. So hang out with me today. I'm gonna go through some going through the motions type stuff, and I'll show you guys how I'm progressing with my my calisthenics and my advanced stuff I'm trying to do on the rings and handstands and parallel bars and all that fun stuff. So I decided I would get this party started with some good old-fashioned barbell squats. And as you guys are about to see, I picked the bar up off the rack. It was only 275, and usually when I start this out, I'll start with 285 for a set of 10. But it's been a while, and I could pick up the, as soon as I picked the bar up, I knew that it was gonna be a little too heavy, and I needed to, you know, work my way back up to it. Probably gonna take like a week or two. But I wanted to leave that in there to show you guys that it's okay to drop the weight. You really need to listen to your body, because you don't wanna have an injury. You don't wanna come back from not training hardcore for a few weeks, and then go right into it on your first workout, and then injure yourself, and be out of the game even longer. So what I'm doing right now for my first exercise is I'm gonna do a burn set. So I'm gonna complete 10 repetitions on every single set, and as soon as I complete those 10 reps, I'm gonna drop the weight. So you'll notice that as I'm doing the exercise, I'm pausing in between each rep. What I'm doing is I'm resetting my breath in between each repetition to ensure my core is as strong as possible. So now what I'm gonna do is just drop the weight down. So this is only 205 right now. And again, I'm gonna go for 10 repetitions, really focusing on form, controlling the weight on the way down and on the way up, trying to keep my chest up as high as possible, and I'm using a bit of a closer foot stance with my feet right now. I typically like to use a close stance. I'll go wider sometimes, but when I'm doing high bar, I feel like I get a lot more power under my hips with my feet a bit closer together. Now the goal with doing the burn sets, if you've never done them before, it's pretty much to push through the pain to get all the repetitions done. So even if you have to rest a little bit at the top of the movement for squats, just keep going, try to do as much as you can without having to re-rack the weight. This is gonna help you build more endurance with your muscles. So again, I'm just gonna drop it right down again. So now I'm gonna put 155 on the bar and hit this again for 10 repetitions. So even though the weight's getting lighter, my legs are already pretty fatigued from doing the first two sets. So it's a non-stop burn set. But what I try to do is as I go lighter and lighter with the weight, I try to complete the reps faster.
I still keep maintaining proper form, but I try to go through them as quick as possible and really feel the burn. Now on to the last drop. I'm just gonna peel the tens off, and then I'm gonna hit 135, 10 reps, and I'm gonna do this as fast as I can. My goal usually with my last set of the burn sets is to do it nonstop. And if you do that, you're gonna find out quite quickly just how much it burns. It feels great. So to switch up the exercises, I decided that, you know, my legs are gonna be pretty fried, so I would alternate between doing things with my upper body as well and work on some of my more advanced calisthenics stuff I'm trying to do. So as you guys can see right now, I'm doing handstands on parallel bars, which I actually just made out of PVC piping. And so, you know, the overall goal with this is to try to hold the handstand as long as you can. And I tell you, it takes a lot of practice. You know, it has a lot to do with, you know, taking in breath, keeping your core tight, and finding the right angle for your body. I started off keeping my feet together, but as I started doing it more and more, I started to realize that if I let my legs kind of spread out, I was able to hold it, you know, longer and longer. So the overall goal with this is to build that upper body strength. I don't know about you guys, but I want to have full control over my body. Lifting weights is great, building muscle is great, but at the end of the day, if you can't even control your own body weight, I mean, what use is that to you, you know? So the first goal is to be able to hold the handstand for a long period of time. The second goal is to be able to hold the handstand for a long period of time and then start to do some bodyweight handstand push-ups. The second leg exercise I decided to do was front squats. Now, I was able to work out this week. I did a chest workout, a tricep workout, and a back workout. And I'll tell you what, even 4 to 5 days later, my muscles are still extremely sore. I'm having a hard time with my flexibility, which is very important when you're doing a front squat. You need to be able to get your hands under the bar and then elevate your elbows as high as possible. And so once again, I'm going light with my weight. I'm doing a little bit of a pause at the bottom of the movement just to work on my range of motion and to work on pushing through my heels. But I am having a hard time at this point with my arms because my back is actually so tight. Believe it or not, having a tight back will pull your arms down and then make the exercise much harder in terms of trying to hold the bar on your shoulders. The second exercise I wanted to do for my upper body strength was a front lever on rings. And so I'm just learning how to do all this stuff. And so what I'm doing right now is I'm just practicing holding that movement. And so I'm just rotating my body forward and backwards. You can see that I'm rotating the rings as well. And I'm trying to go for sets of 10 repetitions. As soon as I finished that set, I waited about a minute and then I jumped back in again to try to do 10 more reps. As you can see, I mean, I'm contracting all the muscles in my upper body, really trying to hold that. As I get better with this, I'll be able to hold that front lever for longer and longer. I decided to do one more set of front squats after doing the front lever with the rings. I tried to stretch out a little bit more before doing the exercise, and then came back over here. As you can see, keep my chest up nice and high. I'm holding my breath on the way down and on the way up, making sure that I'm keeping my core nice and tight, keeping it as strong as possible. And the one thing that I was happy about with this is I was able to complete the repetitions. Usually if I don't do this for a while, it bothers my wrists a lot, but I was able to really get in there, go nice and deep, bring it all the way up and complete a good set. After the front squats, I decided that I would give the static leg raise a try. And so basically with this exercise, I mean, the only way to get better at it is to hold it as long as you possibly can. And as you can imagine from doing the other work, you know, I'm a bit fatigued at this point, but that's okay. It's just gonna make me have to dig deeper to hold it longer. The next exercise I decided to do was a stiff leg deadlift. Now, I know for my body, if I don't hit my hamstrings hard for a couple weeks, and then I decide to hit them, that, oh my, you know what? A rooster just went out in front of my house, and it kind of just threw me off. Turkey, just wanted to show you guys that. But anyway, so for this exercise, I like to do it nice and slow and really work on my form because I know it's gonna hammer my hamstrings. And to be honest, as soon as I left the gym after doing this exercise, I could already feel my hamstrings starting to get pretty tight. So I'm glad that I did this with light weight, but I should be able to bump the weight up even higher in no time. The next exercise I decided to work on for my upper body was the human flag. And I actually have a method of what I'm doing right now. What I'm trying to do is work on my post and bringing my legs up at the same time. So I'm working a lot of core and I'm working on a lot of upper body strength. The goal is to keep your bottom arm stiff and use that as a post. And then for your top arm, you can either try to, you know, bend it to hold yourself in the air. But as you get really good, you should be able to hold the exercise with both arms straight out. I was actually getting pretty good at these before I left for my trip to the UK. So what I'm doing right now is I'm doing sets of 10 per side, just bringing my leg up in the air and then bringing the other one up and then contracting everything as hard as I can and then bringing it back down and resting and then repeating. The last exercise I decided to do for my legs was an alternating stepping lunge. Just using light weights, I'm only using a pair of 25-pound dumbbells, and I'm doing a nice controlled step, and I'm really focusing on making sure both knees hit a 90-degree angle, and I'm pushing through my entire foot on the way back. And this is a really great exercise. It's gonna hit the glutes, it's gonna hit the quads, and for me, it's nice to do at the end. I know I'm gonna be tight tomorrow, so I decided that if I was to do this at the end of the routine, it could help me just kind of loosen things up a little bit before I left. And after doing the stepping lunge, I decided to end it with a quick abdominal exercise. This is a simple ball crunch with a weight. You guys can see I'm using dumbbells to hold my feet in place. And also, you'll notice that I'm holding the weight behind my head, and I'm only using a 10-pound plate. I see a lot of people do this exercise, and they hold like a 25 or a 35 or a 45-pound plate across their chest. When you hold the weight across your chest, you're actually kind of restricting your range of motion. And to be honest, if you hold the plate behind your head, obviously because you're holding it higher, it makes the exercise a bit harder, so you don't have to grab a huge plate to make it an intense exercise for your abs. I mean, you can do this with a 5-pound plate and try to do 20 reps, and you're gonna probably feel it a lot more than if you were to hold a 25-pound plate across your chest.
Well, that wasn't too bad, but the funny thing is just from doing that little bit of work, I can already start to feel my quads and my hamstrings starting to tense up. So for me, all I'm gonna do tonight is I'm just gonna kind of foam roll my legs out and just ease back into it, warm up, do air squats at home, different things just to keep the blood flowing and stay loose, because now it's time to go. Hardcore Nation! For more great tips, exercises, and routines, feel free to join us in ScottHermanFitness.com. And as always, more good stuff coming soon. See you guys.